Hi, boys and girls. Before we begin our lesson today, I want you to make sure that you get out your paper clock. It is in your math folder of new materials that I sent home for you. It's really important. You need it. You're going to be using it during this lesson, so please make sure you have that out. So for our lesson today, lesson two, telling time to the hour, we will begin with a 5-minute warm-up. We will learn to tell time to the hour on an analog clock. We will solve the problem of the lesson, and then we will learn to tell time to the hour on a digital clock. You're probably most familiar with digital clocks. All right, so we're going to begin with the activity where we name the time for different things. So here's a little girl waking up to go to school. Now, we all wake up at different times, so you could wake up at 6 or 7 or maybe even 8 o'clock. So we're going to put it somewhere in the middle. So if she were to wake up at 7 o'clock, we could write that as words. 7 o'clock. Or we can write it another way. Because in math, we always have different ways to express ourselves. So you could also write it as 7 for the hour. Then you'll have these two little dots that separate the hour from the minutes. And o'clock means 0 minutes. But in time, in hours, hours have 60 minutes. And 60 is a double-digit number. So we want to make sure we have enough room to write a double-digit number, because we may need to write all the way up to 59 minutes, so we need to have a space for a double-digit number, so we always use two zeros. So 7, then our two dots to separate the minutes, o'clock, which means 0 minutes, so 7 o'clock, and then we're going to talk about the time of day that it is. It's happening in the morning, so that means it's happening before noon, and if something is happening before noon, we say a.m. The AM stands for a Latin phrase, ante-meridian, which means before midday or before noon. So this is happening before noon. So 7 o'clock, or we could say 7 a.m. Let's look at the next activity. Here she is arriving at school. Now our school day begins at 8:25, so a lot of people start arriving at 8 o'clock. So we would write that as 8 o'clock. So here's how you write it with the words, 8 o'clock, and then if we're going to write it in the other format, we would say 8 for the hour, our two dots to separate the minutes, o'clock means 0 minutes, and remember we always have to use two of them, and then it's also happening before noon, so we say a.m., so 8 o'clock or 8 a.m. If we look at the next activity, here she is. She's had a busy day and now she's going to bed. I want you to notice the sky is dark, okay? So I've been teaching first grade a long time and I know first graders go to bed at different times. Some of you might go to bed at 7:30. Some of you might go to bed at 8. Some of you might even go to bed at 8:30. So let's put that somewhere in the middle. So how about 8 o'clock? So she's going to bed at 8 o'clock. So again, we're writing the word 8 o'clock, and then we're going to write it in the other form, 8, separating our minutes, o'clock. Now this is the same time, is it though? This is happening before noon. Is this happening before noon? No, it's happening in the evening. So if it happens after noon, we say PM. That stands for post-meridian, which means after midday or afternoon, sometime afternoon. So 8 o'clock or 8 PM. All right, let's move to the next activity. Okay, for this part of the lesson, we're learning to tell time to the hour on an analog clock. This is an analog clock. in order to tell time on an analog clock, you have to kind of understand some of its pieces. The front of the clock, or this round part of the clock, is called the face of the clock because it's kind of round like a face. And then these pointy things are called the hands of a clock. There are two different ones, and they're different lengths. You'll notice them on your clock. One is short and one is long. The short one is the hour hand, and the long one is the minute hand, which is kind of unusual because the hour is much longer than a minute, and a minute is much shorter than an hour. So you just kind of have to remember, the hour hand is short, the minute hand is long. I also want you to note that when the minute hand is pointing to the 12, that means 0 minutes have passed. So that's what we call an o'clock, because it's the hour but no minutes. It's just the hour and no extra minutes. So for example, this is pointing to the 1, the hour hand is pointing to the 1, and the minute hand is pointing to the 12. So we would say 1 o'clock. We would write it 1 o'clock. Okay, so what I'm going to have you do is we're going to model some times, and as we model them, I'd like you to also model them on your clock, okay? So let's move that hour hand. So it's pointing to the 3, and the minute hand is still pointing to the 12, so it's 3 o'clock. All right, are you ready to begin? I'm going to show you a time on the clock, and I want you to model the same time on your clock. And once you've got it modeled, I'm going to ask you to tell me what time that is. What time is that? Right, 5 o'clock. Okay, let's do another one. Model it on your clock. Tell me what time that is. Let's check it. 7 o'clock. All right, let's do another. Model it on your clock. Tell me what time that is. And let's check. Did you get it? Good, 9 o'clock. We'll do one more. Model it on your clock. Tell me what time it is. 11 o'clock. Good job. All right, we're going to move on to the next part of our lesson. In this part of our lesson, we are solving the problem. So we're going to show the time to the hour. Now, the way it's going to work is I'm going to read the problem to you, and then I would like you to model it on your clock. And then once you've modeled yours, I'll model it on mine so you can check your work, okay? The owl goes to sleep at 6 o'clock in the morning. The owl goes to sleep at 6 o'clock in the morning. Can you model the time on your own clock? All right, I'm going to show you it on my clock, and then you're going to check yourself and see if you did it the same way. Did you model it the same way? Good job. Now on this 6 o'clock in the morning, would that be a.m. or p.m.? That's right. A.m. Ready for the next problem? The dog barks every night at 8 o'clock. Model the time on your clock. The dog barks every night at 8 o'clock. Okay, I'll show you what it'll look like, and you're going to check your clock. Did you make the same time? So if it's happening at night, is that a.m. or p.m.? That's right, p.m. It's afternoon. Okay, and the last problem of the activity. The chipmunk eats an acorn at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. The chipmunk eats the acorn at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Model it on your clock. And let's check it. Did you have your hour hand pointing to the 2 and your minute hand pointing to the 12? Good. And if it's at 2 o'clock in the afternoon, is that a.m. or p.m.? Is it before noon or is it afternoon? That's right. The 2 comes after the 12, so it's afternoon. So that would be p.m. Good job on problem solving. Now we're going to use our skills to tell time on a digital clock. So let's first model a time on the analog clock. Okay, so I have 2 o'clock, and here it is in a digital time frame. So let's look at the digital clock. Do you see them together? 2 o'clock, 2 o'clock. All right, let's do another time. See if you can model yours as well. Okay. 4 o'clock. And how do we write that on, how would we see that on a digital clock? 4 for the hour, the 2 dots to separate, 4 o'clock. Six o'clock. Eight o'clock. Ten o'clock. 12 o'clock. 12 o'clock. I think digital clocks are much easier to read because it's the hours are first. You always say the hour first, 12, and then that separates o'clock. And we're just working with time to the hour right now, so it's pretty simple. So 12 o'clock. I hope this has made sense for you and that it will help you with your activities. Have a good day.